In this video, I'll show you step by step how to create a YouTube channel for the first time, and I'll show you exactly which buttons to click. I will also show you the most important settings to get the best start on YouTube. At the end of this video, you will be completely set up and ready to upload your first video. My name is Dexxter Clark from the Netherlands, and I'd love to be your guide in starting a YouTube channel with my tips, tricks and tutorials on this channel. If you'd like that, then you should definitely subscribe and hit the bell icon so you will never miss a video. For this video, I've created a checklist that, to be honest, I'm using myself so I don't forget anything. I will send it to you by email. All the steps of this tutorial are in this checklist. The link is in the description. We first have to make sure that you have a Google account. If you don't have one, we should create one. If you already have a Google account, a Gmail account, for example, you can write here on accounts.google.com, can directly sign in. For now, I'm gonna create an account, and I can create an account for myself or to manage my business. Don't create an account for yourself because you have limited possibilities. Use an account for my business. So now you have to provide your first name, last name, username, and a password, and click next. Then fill out your birth date and your gender. Click next. We agree to these terms of service. Confirm. Now it opens the Google Apps window over here. If it isn't here, then you can click over here. Now go to YouTube, sign in, click on your avatar here, and click on create a channel. Your journey begins, get started. Now it asks how you want to create your channel. There are two channels. A personal channel and a business channel. A personal channel has some limitations. Always choose a business channel. For example, you can choose a custom channel name, and you can't do that with a personal account. You also can't add managers to your YouTube account. The problem is that you can't switch later. So always choose a business account over here. Select. Then a channel name. My new super channel, I understand. Click create. You can change this later if you want, by the way. You can upload a profile picture. This isn't necessary because you can change it later. So we are going to the next step. Tell what your channel is about. My channel is about creating YouTube videos. This about section is the section that you will see when you go to your channel. You have here the tabs, and when you go to the tab about, then you will have a description over here, and you can fill that out here, but you can also change it later, so don't worry about it too much. Now you can add links to your YouTube channel, and those are the links that are over here. For example, my website. And we can hit save and continue. We can set this up later, so it doesn't matter that much. Technically, we're done now. We have a YouTube channel and we can upload our first video. Something you have to know is that this is the public part of YouTube, but there's also a private part that is the management system of YouTube that is called YouTube Studio. You can go to YouTube Studio by clicking on your avatar over here and then click on YouTube Studio, and now it will open YouTube Studio. Over here is the dashboard, videos, those are the videos you've uploaded. You have none right now. You can create some playlists, you can see the statistics of your videos, you can manage comments over here, you can manage subtitles over here, monetization, audio library, some settings, and you can send feedback to the YouTube team. If you want to know more about YouTube Studio, I've got a step-by-step tutorial about YouTube Studio. The link is in the description. Now let's do some settings. Let's go over here to your avatar, click on your channel. This will take you back to the regular public view of YouTube. You have two buttons over here, YouTube Studio and Customize Channel. We are going to customize the channel. So click customize channel. Now we are able to manage some stuff. Also here we can manage our avatar if we want to. Click on edit. And now here we can upload a photo. And we click done. Here you can also change your channel name if you want. But if you do that, if you change your profile picture or your channel name, it may take a couple of hours before the changes are changed throughout the whole Google ecosystem. Now we can close this tab. We can change our channel banner. You can do this by clicking on the pencil icon over here. Then it will show a menu. You can edit the links. Those are the links over here. Or you can edit your channel art. And that's what we're going to do now. You can drag and drop a photo here, or you can select a photo and open it. If you want a free template, I will put a link to a PSD file in the description below. Sometimes it takes 2 or 3 tries to upload the channel banner. Now it went okay within the first try, but sometimes you need a couple of times and it gives an upload error. Now we have uploaded this picture and we select select. Now YouTube will put the channel banner over here. Okay, now let's add some extra links to over here. Edit links. Now it will take me to the edit version of the about page. And over here I can add an extra link, for example, my Instagram. And I hit add. And now you will see it will add the Instagram over here. One thing that I think you should do is add a click to subscribe link over here. You can do this by clicking on the pencil icon over here, click on edit links. Now over here it says my website. We're gonna change this to click to subscribe. Then over here we take the first part. So youtube.com/channel/your-channel-id. The rest we're gonna forget. The first part we're gonna copy. So from here we press Ctrl C on Windows or Command C on the Mac to copy this, and we going to replace this, Ctrl V to paste this, and now we going to add a question mark, type in sub_confirmation=1. Now click done. Now you'll see that this over here has changed. When we click on that, it will open the channel and asks if you want to subscribe. And if I click subscribe, I'm subscribed. But in this case, I'm going to click cancel. Now let's go to home over here and let's add a section over here. We can choose between a couple of different items. What I suggest you to do is to put a playlist over here, a single playlist. Now we can add a playlist. The problem is only we don't have created a playlist yet, so this won't work. But let's click over here and let's go to YouTube Studio. And now let's create a playlist. Click over here, add new playlist. Playlist title, my new playlist. The visibility, I wanted to have it to public because I want to add it to my channel homepage. Click create, and now it takes me to my playlist. Let's go back to my channel. Click on customize channel again. Again, click on add section. Select playlist, a single playlist on a horizontal row. Select my playlist, find playlist. Well, I've only one playlist here, my new playlist, and click done. If there are any videos in this playlist, now there are none, then they will show up here. One thing that I think you should also add is a business email. then go to About. Then over here, for business inquiries, add your email address and click Done. You will get spammed on this email address. There will be phishing attempts sent to this email address. And if you have a separate email address for your Google account and a separate email address for your business inquiries, you always know that all the emails that come via this email address are sent from your About page on YouTube. Okay, now let's go to YouTube Studio because we are going to fill out some details. YouTube Studio, and on the left bottom corner over here we have settings. Click on settings. Over here in general, use your currency. In my case that's euro. Then over here is basic info. You can add some keywords that describe your channel. For example, for my channel I would type in for Social Video Plaza YouTube tutorials and press enter. And you can delete them by clicking over here. Those keywords are not really important for search, but it helps the YouTube algorithm to determine what your channel is about. So let's add this again, tutorials. Your country, that is important to set. In my case, that's the Netherlands. This is some legal stuff, so fill this out correctly. You might think that if I fill in the Netherlands that it won't promote my videos to a US audience. That's not true. It will promote my content to a US audience and the rest of the world. Let's go to advanced settings. And over here it asks me to specify if this is a channel for children, yes or no. If your main target is children, you should fill out yes, it's made for kids. If it's not, then if you have a broad audience, click on over here, no, it's not made for kids. To be clear, I'm not a lawyer and I'm not able to give you any legal advice regarding this matter. Something that I would recommend you to do is pick a branding logo over here that is shown on the bottom right corner of your videos. I would suggest you upload a image of subscribe here. So if a viewer hovers over this icon, it gives the viewer a possibility to subscribe. If you, yes, indeed, you can use your own logo if you want, but it doesn't communicate clearly to the viewer that you can subscribe this way. Then over here is feature eligibility. It says over here, default features enabled. And over here, features required for when verifying with a phone. I'm eligible. Click over here because we are going to verify our channel. This means we are able to upload videos longer than 50 minutes and we're also able to use custom thumbnails. Click over here to verify. It wants to have your phone number. You can verify with a text message or they can call you. If you have gone through this process, you will see that over here you have more features enabled because here are listed all the features: uploading, monetization, live streaming, embed live streams, longer videos, etc., etc., etc. If we have done this, then we can close this tab and we go back to the settings. Over here is upload defaults. You don't have to set all the upload defaults, but it can help you to save some time. You can specify a default title. When you upload a video, it has already a default title. Not very useful, but it is useful for a description because you can already put in here all your socials, for example, so you don't have to do that for every single video, every single time. What I would recommend you to do is set a visibility standard to private. There are three states of visibility. There's public, private, and unlisted. Private, nobody can see it. Unlisted is a form between private and public. Only people that have the URL can access the video. And public is available to everyone, and every video you see on YouTube that is available on the YouTube homepage, for example, those videos are all set to public. If we have set those settings, hit save. Now we can upload our first video. How to do that, I'll show you step by step in this video right here. If you want a super quick start on YouTube, you should definitely check out my Ultimate Beginners tutorial right here. If you'd like to see more videos of me, subscribe and hit the bell icon.